Number two, find the fit between the site and the community. Find the resources, collaborate as broadly as possible, and there's a fifth one. Focus on authenticity, which is the first principle of it. So we stand on four basic platforms in terms of how we develop the organization. First of all, historic preservation. Secondly, heritage tourism development as a growth industry. Third, information technology, the infrastructure of communication, social media, and lastly, hospitality training and services. And if you don't know who A. Philip Randolph and the Pullman Porter movement was in terms of the CIO and the development of the unions that took us into the civil rights movement, then you're missing part of the struggle, the long-term struggle that we've gone through seeking our economic emancipation. That's what it's about at this point. If they ain't talking about where the job is, where's the economic coming from, how do we get the dollar going around 8, 9, 10 tax, I would suggest that you don't want to be in that conversation. Because it's about being entrepreneurs, rebuilding the tax base, making sure our dollars go around 8, 9, 10 tax. That's where you get stable communities. You can literally see the line between how the white people get the resources and how the black community is not getting the resources. And that line right now is at 18th Street. I can take you to 18th Street now and look north, and nothing was there 10 years ago. All right, it is now completely redeveloped, and they're pushing southward, and the arrogant white supremacists are saying, you've been here long enough, you poor people need to move, so we can gentrify the neighborhood and use your tax dollars to do it. Mm-hmm. Right, that's what's on every block right now. And I get to the point where I get into the discussion with them, and wind up calling them out, and then some of them front like they're black, but they're really white people. All right, and then you do have those black elites. I don't have to, see, you know, I don't like to throw the brick no more. I used to throw the brick, all right? This is a new book, Racial Democracy in the Black Metropolis. So this guy took him 12 years to write this book, started in 2000. What is his basic thesis? His basic thesis is there are a group of elitist blacks who have, in fact, captured the real estate market on behalf of the white power structure, and have systematically disenfranchised by deflating the real estate market so that low-income people do not have decent and safe affordable housing. So we're caught up in what you see happening in public housing. I can tell you people in 1940 said you cannot take a rural black person, family, move them up into a high-rise apartment, cut them off from everything that they knew from a rural perspective, and expect anything to happen that didn't happen in public housing in terms of the breakdown of the black family structure. And in that scenario, over generations, the parents, you had to leave the house as the head of household on the ABC, right? The man had to leave the house so the wife could get the check, right? So you do that for two generations. And in public housing, then you got the children, the older children, having sex with the younger mothers in the public housing, and those generations have been born. So at the end of the public housing scenario, you had 13, 14-year-olds running around in gangs, killing each other over the drug turf that you saw all up and down State Street, where the red building was going against the gray building. I mean, that kind of madness is what we just endured. Don't say nothing about the formation of that first generation of blacks who came up in the 1950s, when they stopped the train, didn't stop the 12th Street, it actually stopped at 63rd Street, and that's when they influxed that first generation of blacks, who Jeff Ford and them all represented. Those groups were coordinated by the churches and the University of Chicago into the gang structures that became the Gangster of Disciples and the Blackstone Rangers. Mm-hmm. And they used them people to gentrify Woodlawn. Go through Woodlawn today. You see a handful of liberal white people, most of the black people are gone, the land has been cleared, University of Chicago runs it from 59th Street to the graveyard, Cotton Grove, Stony Island. Go across King Drive and stand on the corner of 51st Street and you almost look through the 59th Street and turn to middle class housing that was demolished over that period of time. So it's about, and always will be about, the real estate. And that don't change. So what we're doing is talking about it, key people in Brownsville. I gave you the three people that I'm
really keyed on. What we do and why we're promoting, and I'll give you another document.
This is our heads, guys. Again, we're talking about promoting
multiple sites.